Hey there, home stretch, step seven, submitting that application. So I'm gonna hope you've got this memorized by now, right? You're reading those funding guidelines, you prepped your narrative skeleton, you've got a fabulous grant schedule, you hosted a kickoff, you're gonna have a great budget, you are going to knock out your attachments, most commonly the resolution and letters of support. You've written a totally amazing narrative, and now it is time to press submit. So you're on the home stretch, and in this lesson, we're gonna cover a couple of things. One is packaging your application, how you should do that, the importance of an independent review, how to host a debrief meeting, and how to share your wins and lessons learned. So a couple tips for design, because this really does matter. You want to put some thought into how to make your grant as enjoyable to read, as easy to understand, so that your reviewer just has quick comprehension and they don't get stuck trying to understand what you're saying. So if your grant is particularly competitive, you might consider engaging a graphic designer. You can find some great ones on Upwork, a global freelance website. Then if you have very strict guidelines, which is common, where it might be like Times New Roman, size 12, 1-inch margins, that doesn't matter. You still can be very creative with bold italics and underline and different size font for your headers. So you still want to put a lot of effort into figuring out how, even in this very text-dominant narrative, can you make it easier to understand. And graphics can be very simply prepared, and it really helps make your grant easier to understand. And also fair game, I'm doing this more and more. We've got a project going right now where it's kind of an intense problem they're solving, and so we will be including photos in that narrative. So there's no shame in doing that as well. We are much more visual, right? But our grant narratives haven't caught up. My theory in the future is that grant narratives might just be videos, right? They might not all be written text. So here's one pro tip for improving the understanding of your project plan. You might need to include a schedule. This schedule is literally built with Google Table, right? So just drawing out the amount of rows and columns you need and reformatting them with color, and bam, you have this totally gorgeous looking Gantt chart that is super easy to prepare. Now, when you're packaging your attachments, the trick here is to not go way overboard, right? We want to very tastefully support the application, but not throw everything in the kitchen sink inside of it. So create an attachment list, which is best to do at the very beginning, and we do teach how to do that in the Grant Writing From Start to Funded. And then identify what attachments need signature, because those are the pieces that if you can get the signature knocked out ahead of time, you want to do that. The last thing you want to be dealing with is the grants due and you forgot to get signature on a couple things. And then when you're titling those attachments, which are most often uploaded as PDFs, try to keep it really simple. So do something like your name, underscore, if an underscore is allowed, budget.pdf, or your name, underscore narrative. Like, it's no question what that is, right? Now, you always, always want a second set of eyes on your work, because no matter how good you are, you've probably been looking at this thing a million times and you're kind of over it and you can make mistakes. So an independent reviewer is someone that is not deeply involved in writing the application, and then they can have this fresh set of eyes looking at it and make sure that you have not made any silly errors. I had a colleague once forget the last page of her narrative. Totally weird, fluky deal, right? And that was a very competitive grant application. So had there been a proper independent review process in place, that would have been caught, right? So your reviewer is also checking for hyperlinks working, making sure all the attachments are there, consistency in terminology, etc. This is not a time for substantial narrative edits. So word to the wise, a lot of times this might be, you know, you're bringing it to the kind of final reviewer, maybe your director or whoever needs to kind of finally bless it. And all of a sudden they want to do massive changes and it's right before the deadline. You don't want that to happen. And that's why it's really important to be bringing along everyone that's key and making sure that they're reviewing substantial drafts, so there's no surprises and no surprise changes that you have to deal with at the end. So here's that application checklist in brief that we have in the course to kind of help you navigate this process, because we were just finding the more complicated grants that we started taking on, really the more we needed to have a good process for, okay, here it is, here's where you can go access it, the link in the Google Drive folder, ready for review, and once it was approved, it could have a signature or a initials there, and it really helped streamline things. Okay, now, how do you find a reviewer? It's essential for success. So if you don't have that accountability buddy who's been kind of following along, they make good independent reviewers. But if you can't find somebody within your organization that can do it, it's really helpful to have another grant writer that can look over it. And that's another additional benefit of the private community group that we have in Grant Writing from Start to Funded. So this is what you can expect. Most applications are submitted online. Very rarely are they still paper-based. Does happen, but it's not common. If you are inputting your responses into an online form, remember, please take all of those narrative responses and have them in a separate document that is independently reviewed, and then you go and input them into the online form, right? So that you don't have any, sometimes those online forms don't have like typo checks and stuff. Then you're usually going to be uploading your narrative and any attachments as PDFs unless otherwise specified. Sometimes a budget will be uploaded directly as like a Google Excel spreadsheet. So it just depends on what your funding guidelines instruct, but that is generally what you can expect. All right, and then it is go time. You're submitting your application. You're all pumped because you've worked super hard. A few things to keep in mind. You want to be submitting that application at least 24 hours early, preferably more, because A, it just stands out that you're getting your work in ahead of time and that bodes well for reputation, but B, because things happen. And so you want to be giving yourself that wiggle room. There is no reason to be going up to the deadline like that's a badge of honor, right? Because you will make mistakes. We just want to be done a day or two or three even early. Now, you want to also screenshot your notification that the grant was received and be sure to save that in a project folder. So sometimes you don't get an email, which is a little weird, but it happens. So be sure that you're saving documentation it was submitted. Just to warn you, when you press submit, it is scary whether it's your first grant or it's your 50th. For some reason, it just creates a lot of adrenaline in your system because you're like, gosh, I haven't made any mistakes, have I, right? So just be prepared to have a plan to release that adrenaline afterwards. You're not just going back to your regular work day, I can tell you that. So go take a walk, go have some friend, go meet up with a friend for lunch, like have something planned to kind of diffuse that energy out of your body so that then you can roll into whatever it is that you're tackling next. Now, before you let the time get away from you too much, it's very important to have a debrief meeting with your team. And I'll tell you what, a lot of times when a grant maybe didn't end on the most positive of note, people don't want to have these, but this is how you break through and have really strong dynamic teams. So you want to be having this within a week of submitting your grant. You're going to host this internal debrief meeting and talk about what went well, what could be improved. I know it's tempting to skip, but seriously, just don't do it because this is what makes you an amazing project manager and breaks out those habits that can be a little tough for an organization to shed. Right? And then you're going to save the notes from the meeting in terms of what the lessons learned, put that in the project folder, and then before you pick up a next grant, be sure to review it so you can make sure you're baking those lessons learned into your grant proposals moving forward. And then you're done. You've submitted your big grant application. I wish you had, you know, a bowl of confetti that you could throw and celebrate, right? Because I remember the first time I submitted my first large grant, it was $600,000 for a tribal clinic. And I remember thinking at the time that if I did not receive that grant, I was going to quit my job because my employer was surely going to know. I didn't have any idea what I was doing, right? Like a lot of negative talk, a lot of lack of confidence. And I'm so glad the grant was successful, so I didn't irrationally quit my job, right? But I want you to know that nobody bats 100%, myself included. And so just recognize that this gap between when you're waiting to hear, it can be a little bit weird, but don't let that noise get into your system and let it just scrape away at your confidence, because I guarantee you know more than you think you do, right? And then the other thing is, that is why it's so important to be focusing on the right grants in the first place, so that if you are going to put all this effort into something, you feel pretty darn confident that it should be successful. So with that, congratulations, you have learned the 7 steps to writing winning grant applications. We legitimately apply every step that we've described to you in the consulting side of our house. Everyone we train, They use the same process. It really, really works when you learn something that you can just deploy over and over and over again. Because at the root of successful grant writing, frankly, is successful project management. So now let's jump into the next section of these videos, which is going to talk about what you can expect to run into next and what you can do about it to prepare. That's it. I will see you over there next.